And another 11 News update now on a high drama story we first reported weeks ago.
A Jewish Community Watch Group member is accused of beating an African American teen, and tonight, leaders from both the African American and Jewish communities gathered to talk about their concerns. 11 News reporter Kai Reed was at the meeting earlier tonight, and she joins us now with more from the 11 Newsroom Live. Kai?
Well, Marianne and Rob, the two-hour closed-door meeting was held at the Jewish Community Center, included 25 religious and political leaders from the Jewish and African-American communities. Reporters were not allowed inside that meeting, but attendees described it as heated at times, yet productive.
While outside, about a dozen or so frustrated community members voiced their displeasure about not being allowed into the closed-door meeting.
Community representatives are out here, and we are quite concerned.
Inside, the group of invited religious and political leaders discussed the alleged beating of a 15-year-old boy last month and the state of Jewish and African-American relations in the community.
It is our strong feeling that we can resolve this matter and that in the future we are going to work together to make sure that an event like this does not happen again.
I think it's very clear that what we want to have are a series of educational and communal opportunities so that everybody can not only understand this particular incident, but grow again to remind ourselves why we care about each other.
Court documents allege that 23-year-old Eli Wertesheim struck the 15-year-old boy with a radio on November 19th in northwest Baltimore. He was doing patrol with the community watch group Shomrim at the time. Prior to tonight's meeting, some religious and community leaders had called for Shomrim to be disbanded.
The question has somebody, a member of the group, done something that should not have been done? And if he did, how are you going to deal with that? And we need more information.
We need more information and feedback as to how they're organized, how they're structured, and so that we can critique them to see if there is more training that has to be done.
Now, community leaders at the meeting said that this is just the first step, a preliminary discussion. They said that there will be more fact gathering about the incident specifically and more meetings about community relations that will likely include a larger group of people. Reporting live in the newsroom, Kai Reed, WBAL-TV 11 News.